With Daybreak, let's continue that conversation. Kagusha, you had a point to me.
Yeah, of course I had a point. Yeah. You know, what surprised me is when Mheshimiwa said that Raila put the country ahead of everything. And he went ahead to say, or he goes ahead to say that even swearing himself and committing an act of treason.
No. I said
is part of.
We swore ourselves as the
Just let me finish. Mheshimiwa. You know, he puts putting the country ahead in the same sentence and paragraph with swearing himself at Uhuru Park. I don't know if another person was to swear themselves at the Uhuru Park, whether that would also be part of putting this country ahead of everything else. And of course, you know that is treasonable, and you know that is not right. And of course, you know that brought memories of other things that had happened in the 80s. Now, we have a challenge where my brother says that Raila has not appointed any person in cabinet or PSs or CSs in the last two regimes. Either Mheshimiwa has not lived in this country, or I don't know whether Mombasa is too far from Nairobi to understand that Raila has actually been a prime minister in this country not so long time ago, actually. And that even in this administration, as we are talking, quite a number of people who had been put in government by Deputy President were actually replaced by those who were appointed by Raila Odinga. And a lot of names that were forwarded to His Excellency the President have now been appointed as CASs, as PSs, and many others in various positions. And that Raila is actually a co-principal in this handshake government. We had the Jubilee government that lasted only 5 years. And the truth of the matter is, practically speaking, the government we have today is not the Jubilee government. It is a handshake government, which is run by two individuals, His Excellency the President, Uhuru Kenyatta, and the former Prime Minister, Raila Odinga. Those are the people running government now, and they have been doing it for the 5 years. And of course, my brother here says that Deputy President blocked the BBI. But I also want to remind him, it is the judiciary, it is a court of law that blocked BBI. It is a court of law that said BBI was unconstitutional. Even though BBI may have had anything good for this country, it was done in the unconstitutional manner. And the courts did not allow that. It was stopped. And as we are talking today, it is in the Court of Appeal. I mean, and rather, it's in the Supreme Court, because even the Court of Appeal agreed with the High Court that we had a problem with the process in which we took the BBI. And that is where we are having a problem as the people who ascribe to the UDA and to the Hustler movement, that you can spend a whopping 4 years pushing an agenda in this country, removing people from the Big Four agenda, which the Jubilee government of the first 5 years had intended to do and to achieve. And then you take the next 5 years, you take this country from the right footing, the right focus, put it on a BBI agenda, and then force it through the throats and through the minds of Kenyans and do it in the wrong way. Well, there could have been good things about this BBI. But look, you want to do things in an unconstitutional manner, and you want to do this for 4 years. You take Kenyans for a ride for 4 years, and people waste all their resources, all their imagination on a document that consumed billions of shillings that would have been used to develop business, to grow business, to do development in this country, and all this money goes down the drain. Why? Because we want to glorify an individual, we want to justify an individual, we want to say that this individual has been the savior of this country, have brought this country from I don't know where to where, that the reason why I'm seated here is because of an individual. Yet, we fail to appreciate the fact that this country has had a system. We have had many people who have been in the third liberation. It is not one individual person who has been in the third liberation of this country or the second or whatever liberation. It is many people who have participated in the you know, freedoms that we enjoy today. We have had many politicians, we have even had clergy, we have had business people, we have even had individuals even ourselves by what we have been propagating in the media, yeah. we are also part of this liberation, okay. which continues to take place. And so, don't tell us about a person. Don't tell us about an individual. Tell us about the systems, the policies that this government or whichever government is going to be putting in place.
Okay,
like
good.
We are saying yeah. in the Hustler movement,
yeah.
we have a system, we have policies, we have legislation that is going to be supporting business
okay.
for the masses, that is going to ensure that whatever resources that are put in this economy are going to be growing this economy from bottom, and that way we'll
yeah.
be able to support. And by the way, the move, the policies that we are propagating are the same policies now that even President Biden in America is propagating,
okay.
whereby you stop doing tax cuts for the tycoons, for the bourgeoisie, for the people who hold the capital and the factors of economic growth in this country. You now start focusing on people who are a little bit lower in the pyramid.
Okay.
And of course, what now we are seeing is that the Raila's candidacy, which has in the past been for the movement of the masses of the masses of this country, has now been taken over, has been enslaved, now has been trapped in a small community of the bourgeoisie, the 5% or just 1% of the Kenyan rich men who now have owned, you know, this cause and they want to push it. Why? Because they want to get better favorable tax cuts, they want to get better favorable economic models that favor them. And of course, that is what is pressurizing our young people and our majority of Kenyans. That's why 14 million Kenyans today, yeah. as we talk, are actually on CRB.
Okay.
Can you imagine? 14 million Kenyans are on CRB, and the rich today don't care so much about that. They are the same ones who are propagating the Fulizas. They are the same ones who are propagating
yeah.
these high interest loans that are given to the young people or and to the women of this country. Can you imagine today, even a lot of these rich people are propagating the betting culture. You know, people are selling their goats and their chicken to bet.
Okay.
For this money to go to the same people who are
okay.
now financing these campaigns.
All right, let me just get this clear. Are you against the Raila candidature, or are you against people who you probably perceive stole from you? I don't know, because your discussion is a bit. Where I come from, there's a saying.
The bottom of the pyramid.
Where I come from, there's a saying that if you want to be a liar, you better have a very good memory. First of all, Raila did not swear himself in. We swore him in, and we take responsibility.
You carried him to Uhuru Park?
Myself and all the others. He did not swear himself in. And secondly, there's no act of treason. And that's the reason why yourself and others who at that time you felt very, very comfortable with were unable to actually charge him with treason. We saw him as the people's president. He still is the people's president till today. You like it or you hate it. It's up to you. Secondly, the charges that you always try and insinuate the prime minister on in the 1980s, he was charged in August 1982. By March of 1983, those charges were dropped. He was detained, put in with no trial whatsoever. In fact, at that time, there was the public security regulations. There were not even laws that were detaining this gentleman. For a good almost 9 years of his life, he ended up being detained. This was just one of the excuses that was used for him to be detained. And when you mentioned that Raila has been prime minister before, yes, he has. And let me tell you what happened when he was prime minister. When he was prime minister, it was a time when this country was able to actually say that we need free primary school education, and it happened. It's the time. Shake your head, nod your head, but I'm hoping that you're nodding it in appreciation. During his time, the SGR was signed at a lesser amount of money. Today, we're grappling in debt. That debt that was signed during a time when the deputy president was in full command of this country. You cannot tell us that as part of an executive, he was not even able to do anything else. During the time of Raila Amolo Odinga, the SGR debt was at about 2 point something. They went and re-signed this debt months after coming in as the Jubilee government. Months after coming in as the Jubilee government. Today, as the Coastal people, we're crying out, and Raila Amolo Odinga is supporting us in this cry, that we need to relook at how we're going to get out of the debt shackle. That courtesy of the same person that you are trying to glorify that has an economic model. That economic model, he should have implemented it when he was the deputy president. And I'm insisting on this again and again. The best economic model that this country needs right now is stop stealing. It's simple as that. Stop stealing. Stop stealing. You're stealing. And the worst part is, and I'm using this, you're extorting poverty. You steal, and after stealing, you go back and you tell the same person that, you know, oh dear Lord, I realize that you have nothing else here for breakfast. You just sold 3 trays of eggs from him, and you're giving him 1 egg. And in most cases, you end up leaving people. Have you seen what is happening? Do you realize who actually is causing chaos? Do you know, whenever the person that you are trying to glorify his economic models, let me tell you the economic models that has been happening. Every single time that the deputy president has been going round in this country, have you seen that there's been violence? Violence because you're extorting poverty. You can't go somewhere and tell people that, na wacha hapa milioni mbili na nusu, and you've just left with your chopper. You're leaving people there not knowing how that money is actually being distributed. I come from Mombasa. I know of a boda boda chair that his house was about to be put up in flames. I know people who ended up having problems. It's been the media, the same media that you try and glorify, and you're telling us about Oka principles being let down and the rich are trying to give to Raila Amolo Odinga. Mention that as well, that the people who started burning tires on the street in Central Province because it was perceived that Ruto went there and gave out some money. Mention that, you know, he went out and tried to give some money in Kisumu as well. You're extorting poverty. You're not even Robin Hood. Because you're not stealing from the rich. You're stealing from the same poor people. The same people who are taking Fuliza loans, they're taking those Fuliza loans courtesy of yourself. The same people who are languishing in poverty. The same 14 million people that you're talking about, you caused it. You are the one who caused it. When Raila Amolo Odinga was prime minister, that you rightfully put he was the prime minister, the poverty index in this country was not as it is. So do not tell us anything about that. And first of all, William Samoei Ruto did not even go ahead and even say no to the BBI loan. He led the no campaign in the last time. This is a person who does not believe in devolution. And I'm not saying this because I'm putting words into his mouth. He said it himself. He did not believe in a constitutional change where people, you'd not even be speaker here today. Do you know that? If it was not for Raila Amolo Odinga and the others, I don't know where you were part and parcel of the yes or no then. But Ruto, William Samoei Ruto, was against not just the BBI. And I'll tell you one thing. You want to know the qualities of the person that we're talking about and you feel that we're glorifying him? Let me give you those qualities that he believes in. The BBI process was stopped by the courts. The words that Raila Amolo Odinga used is that we will, as much as we will disagree with what the courts have said, we will respect those decisions. That is Raila Amolo Odinga for you.
Of course, right? You gotta let me finish. Also?
I mean, I let you try and explain things, and I'm saying this again. Where I come from, there's a saying, if you want to be a liar, you better have a very good memory. Because Raila Amolo Odinga fought and is still fighting for devolution in this country. I'm sure where you come from, you've got MCAs. This is the thing that you're talking about, that you're saying that Raila Amolo Odinga actually went behind. You've got MCAs right now who are complaining that there's no development in their particular wards. What Raila fought for in the BBI was that every single ward would have a ward development fund. What Raila fought for is the same thing that you are crying right now, that there's not enough money going into the counties. That he fought for, that the larger percentage of money that is from this national treasury, so that we do not have those political elite who are sitting in national government having a larger cake, not for them to be able to distribute, but for them to be able to continuously eat. Okay. That is the economic model that we believe in.
You know,
stop stealing from the poor, give money back to where it deserves, take money back to the grassroots.
You're
talking about BBI being stopped by the courts. Let me tell you what the courts stopped. The courts stopped millions of Kenyans who appended their signatures as per the IABC regulations. The courts stopped all those counties that actually went ahead and approved the BBI, the court stopped the National Assembly's approval of the BBI, the court stops the Senate's approval of the BBI,
so the court approved the views, Trevor,
and we respect those views.
Gentlemen, let's pull down the tempers a bit now.
But I just need to reply to him and tell him what he's actually describing here is what we have been calling political conmanship. Is specifically that.
I'd rather be a political conman than economic conman.
Where we are saying is political conmanship.
You guys are actually economic conman.
Is by selling a lie. This lie is about stealing. If you stole in Kenya, you'll be in court, you'll be in jail. And you are now having very good control of government systems. And yet, even by using the criminal justice systems, we have not seen, you trying to bring to books the deeds that you're talking about.
Oh, yes, we will.
And of course,
and Raila Molo Odinga, by the way, is saying this. That's why they're panicking.
That is part of the political conmanship you're saying.
Trevor, Raila Molo Odinga in Mombasa said this.
The political conmanship you're talking about is where you come and lie to people that the BBI was supposed to push money into their counties.
Wasn't
yet,
it?
Yet. And of course, it was not.
Oh, come on. It's a document.
I'm talking.
It's a document.
My comment.
Let's hear this argument.
The Constitution today provides that the counties or the devolution should be able to get a minimum of 15%. Mm-hmm. It doesn't say maximum.
Okay.
I mean, do you know where 75% goes? Mm-hmm. It goes to the national government. If, for example, in health, you give a minimum of 15% to the counties, you give 75% to the national government. I mean, that is minimum.
Okay.
It is this constitution that actually allows you to give a maximum of 75% to the county governments or to devolution. I mean, you can be able to do that. The constitution does not in any way inhibit that. It gives us that leeway. In fact, it is constitutional to give 50% to the devolution and 50% to the national government. That has
which part of the constitution is that? Hold on.
When he talks about, of course, the issue
which part of the constitution is that? I mean, I read the constitution on a daily basis.
Our constitution, it gives us minimum 15%. It doesn't give us maximum.
You just talked about 50%.
The political concept is in that you want to portray like it is the new BBI thing. And yet we know very well that BBI was supposed to come and help create positions at the top. BBI, of course you know very well, was supposed to come and create the position of the Prime Minister, the Deputy Prime Ministers, and that is now where the people who ascribe to this Raila Odinga movement now are finding themselves lost. Why? Because they were supposed to have gotten a formula to be able to cater for the Oka group, so that they have a Prime Minister, they have a President, they have several Deputy Presidents, that is what they were supposed to do. Now, that did not work. And because it did not work, we are now where we are. We have now Oka here and Raila here. And of course, one of the things that is being propagated again, and you're going to see this happening in coming days, is that we are still going to be propagating for a constitutional review in the 100 days so that we can still be able to contain this Oka group. This was supposed to be a political solution for that grouping.
Why did your county assembly pass it, though?
Pardon?
Why did your county assembly pass the BBI?
I mean, your guess is as good as mine. Let me tell you. The issue of...
Were you on the chair when they passed it?
I don't pass anything, my friend.
I'm just asking.
I know, as a member of parliament...
Were you on the chair when they passed it?
Of course I was.
Okay.
Of course, you know you know the role of a speaker in an assembly.
No, I mean,
really, the issue is.
But we're just asking
the things, the things that you're propagating here.
Right.
What we're saying, like the steal of the issue of stealing thieves and all that, is now an old cliche. Is an old narrative that the ODM and the handshake movement has been selling.
Yeah.
And now it is old. It is tired.
Okay.
I mean,
gentlemen, how do we ensure? Trevor, I need to just give one statement. You're going to have to allow me this one statement. All right? Now, he's rightfully put it. By the way, the Constitution does not talk about anything in maximum.
Of course.
Please do not try.
I'm happy
now
you have referred back to the Constitution.
No. Do not try and say that the Constitution can give you a maximum of up to 75%. The Constitution does not do that. Actually, you contradicted yourself. You said 50% and 50%, and then you went back and said 15%. Let me tell you what is going to happen.
When it says minimum,
I allowed you to speak. You've got to allow. You've got to allow me. You've got to allow me to say this. And I'm saying this without contradicting anything at all. Raila Amolo Odinga has believed in devolution. You know that. It's been there. 35%. Your candidate, who I have a lot of respect for, not politically. I might have a lot of respect for him because of his resilience in what he believes in, and that is that the fact that he does not believe in devolution, actually refused for us to even have devolution in the first place. He refused and said no to this whole narrative of BBI, and you guys were clapping. And let me tell you why you guys were clapping. Because my worry is, in a William Samoei Ruto presidency, do you know the way they are continuously talking about the Constitution, talking about 15%? I'm worried that counties are gonna get nothing else except 15%. And I think you guys want that. This is the reason why you actually went and came up with, you used the word that it was political conmanship so that you guys can come up with economic conmanship so that you can be able to stay with this 85% on national government, hoping that you will win. Kenyans are smarter than that. You know very well that you guys are not going to win these elections. And, you said that why aren't people going to be jailed? I think Raila Amolo Odinga, and this is the reason why a lot of you guys are going to panic. You have a right to panic, but and it's human nature. Don't worry, you do have a right to panic.
That's like you panicked.
Raila Amolo Odinga,
and now you find yourself.
Raila Amolo Odinga. Allow me to finish. Raila Amolo Odinga said this when he was in Mombasa. Do you remember when Raila Amolo Odinga came to Mvita? We were launching something that I know you guys don't believe in, helping the poor people with medical cover. But when we did that in Vita, he used some words and he said that when we take over, all these people who stole are going to have to explain. And that's when you guys started panicking. I don't blame you for panicking, but I mean, it's only fair. Return the money back to Kenyans.
My friend.
Just return the money back to
right,
Kenyans.
Final remarks, gentlemen. Yeah. We're running out of time here. Kagusha, final remarks.
Yeah, of course, it's clear that my brother here, he says we are panicking, but if you look at the way they are behaving, they're in a very serious panic mode. You know, the arithmetic which had been drawn on March 18th, 2018, when the handshake was done, for Raila Odinga to take over the country has become extremely difficult. Yeah, Kenyans have decided they want to look at an economic model that favors them. They're looking at something that is going to be putting money into their pockets. Kenyans are looking at what we call the minimum guaranteed returns on their cash crop and on their farm produce. Kenyans want, when they sell coffee to external buyers, they want to know that they are going to get 120 shillings per kg in their pocket, and the government can be able to take care of how that money is going to be. But you know, the bourgeoisie here want us to have the cartels that have always done these things, they put together and contained together and protected. And that's why the panic is. And in fact, the arrangement that was there before has now refused to work. And Kenyans have bought into the bottom-up approach, economic model. Even now, the politicians who have never mentioned anything to do with economic models now can talk about it in this country. We are happy. The debate has changed a lot in this country, and we are very proud of where we are going as Kenyans. And I can tell you, it's bottom-up all the way.
Okay.
All right.
Losing the back.
I'll tell you what, at the end of the day, I believe that this country needs an economic revolution. This is something that millions of Kenyans, every single person, believes that this country needs an economic revolution. An economic revolution that the economic situation of this country has been so depressed till, you know, we've got all these people who are on Fuliza loans, we've got people, highest rates of suicides right now. The situation is getting so bad. I would rather trust someone who put out everything else for democratic space in this country and has been tried, tested, and has been found that this is the best person. When he was able to get anything that he wanted, and he said that, no, Kenyans first. I'd rather trust that person. I'd rather trust the person that says that I want money to go back to where it belongs. And I'm speaking to Kenyans directly. A Raila Amolo Odinga presidency is about sending money to the people. A Raila Amolo Odinga's presidency is about saying no to all the stealing and all the corruption that is going on. Raila Amolo Odinga's presidency is a presidency that we are talking about equating people's lives. You know, when people have been so tired, torn out of being extorted by the same people who then come out and give you handouts. Raila Amolo Odinga's presidency is what this country actually deserves and needs. And I'm saying this, and I want everyone to be able to equate, based on the histories of all the individuals who are trying to vie right now. What is it that Raila Amolo Odinga has always stood for? What is it that he has been consistent on? And what it is that we can be able to rely on. I can assure you of one thing. We can be able to rely on a person who has fought for democratic space in this country, to fight for economic space in this country as well.
All right. Thank you so much for making time this morning, Honorable Abdul Samad Sharif, Member of Parliament from Vita, Honorable John Kagushia, Speaker.